derivation or derivation of the formula for simple interest, that is I is equal to PTR upon 100. Here we will derive the formula or calculate the formula on the basis of unitary method. So here let us consider the principal. Principal means, as you know, whatever amount we are depositing or borrowing. So let us consider the principal B, which is P, the rate of interest B, R percentage. This R percentage per year or per annum means for every rupees 100, for every rupees 100, you have to give or the bank has to give R rupees as the interest for 1 year. So this it should be clear for you. Rate of interest R percentage means for every 100 rupees, the person has to give or the bank has to give R rupees as the interest for 1 year. T years be the time. T years is the time and I be the simple interest. So as already I said, R percentage per year means rupees R as the interest for every 100 rupees. For every 100 rupees. For every rupees 100 for 1 year. So the interest of rupees 100 for 1 year. For 1 year equals how much? Rupees R. Interest for rupees 100 for 1 year according to R percentage per annum will be rupees R. Now the interest of, we don't have rupees 100, we have to calculate the interest for P, rupees P. So this 100 we are going to change into rupees 1. For 1 rupees, the interest of rupees 1 for 1 year. Children, here rupees 100, the interest will be given rupees R. R rupees will be given as the interest for 100 rupees. Now for 1 rupee, the interest will be more or less? It will be less, because here 100 we have turned to 1. So it will be less. So what you have to do? You have to divide by 100. Rupees R upon 100. Now the interest for, the interest of rupees 1, here let's now change this rupees 1 into rupees P, because our principal is P. For rupees P for 1 year is equal to rupees. Now you see, 1 we have changed to P. So 1 we have changed to more. So here interest also will be more. So what you have to do? Multiply. So R upon 100 into P. What you have to do? R upon 100 into P. The interest of rupees P. We have what rupees P? 4. Now we don't have 1 year. We have the time as T years. We have the time T years. For T years is equal to rupees. Here again, 1 year you are going to change to T year. Means you have to increase. So what you have to do? You have to multiply over here. So rupees R upon 100 into P into T, or P into T into R upon 100. We are combining this and writing P into T into R upon 100. Once again, let me make you clear. We are having a principal of rupees P and the interest rate is R percentage and the time is T years. We have to calculate the simple interest R. So R percentage per year means for, you have to, you will get rupees R as the interest for every rupees 100 for 1 year. So I am writing it in the sentence. The interest of rupees 100 for 1 year, I will get how much? R rupees as the interest. Now the interest of rupees 1, I am changing this 100 to 1. So what I have to do? I have to divide here by 100. Rupees 1 the interest of, now this one I am changing to P. So here I have to multiply. The interest of rupees P for 1 year will be rupees R upon 100 into P. Again, I don't have the 1 year, I have got 3 years. Again, I have to multiply by T. So the interest of rupees P for T years will be rupees R into P into T upon 100, or P T R upon 100. Simple interest is denoted by the letter I. So therefore, I will be having I is equal to P into T into R upon 100. I will continue in the next video.